ataque. Y después, en esa que me resalten, trato de ver si me trae algún informe. Es como así me suena a mí.
Ok, por ahí te ayuda ya.
Okay, so let's. I was hopefully this should be better for the internet connection. I was in a part of the home where the internet connection was. Let me. Is this better? Can you hear me now?
Parece que no.
Yes, perfect. Yes, I hear you.
Okay, all right. So let us continue. And the chat part. So it's probably right now everything is wiped out on the previous chat, so we'll have to start all over again here. How come I don't see any? Let me see. Manage participants are at 11, so I see everyone. All right. Mm-hmm. I lost the whole connection, so I had to reconnect. Okay. All right. Can you?
Okay.
Okay. Let us hope. Let us. Yes. All right, so how is it now, Patricia?
I hear you perfect.
All right, so we were saying with that, just continuing, we're saying that everything depends upon our knowledge, and our, it is your knowledge that determines your view and your intentions. Mm-hmm.
Lo que dice es que todo depende de nuestra intención, de nuestro conocimiento y de
How is it? Hello? So the knowledge.
You have just said that everything depends on our knowledge and intention.
No, it is our knowledge that determines our view and our intention.
Ah, okay. Depende de nuestro conocimiento. Nuestro conocimiento determina nuestra visión y nuestra intención.
Yeah. Yes. Yes, and it's the simple example, of course, we gave was, you know, the people walking on the street do not know that the person coming across is a great professor in whatever field, you see. You know, and therefore your knowledge changes your view as well as your intention, you see. Hmm?
Esto, por ejemplo, es el ejemplo que estaba dando antes. Encontramos con un profesor y este profesor fue el que nos dio el conocimiento. Vimos a este profesor, sentimos esta gran conexión. Pero esto nos pasa a nosotros, que fuimos los que recibimos.
So our knowledge has been is being continuously modified by the experiences that we, you and I, undergo in life, you see. Mm-hmm. Our knowledge.
Se va a modificar a través de las experiencias que vamos teniendo.
Our knowledge continue to get modified, you see? Modified second by second, our knowledge, or by day, you know, if not second by second, there is everything that is happening is depending upon the knowledge that exists, you see. The knowledge is who you are.
El conocimiento se va modificando día a día. Pero vamos a decir que este conocimiento va modificando todo el día y que existe, se va modificando la visión que tenemos.
Our actions, our feelings, and our opinions, you see. Everything, when you really think about it, is based on your knowledge. Mm-hmm. Go on.
Actions, emotions, feelings, and what else modifies?
And our opinions.
Opinions, thank you. Y este conocimiento que determina nuestra mirada e intención, nuestros sentimientos y nuestras opiniones.
And so this particular sentence that, oh my Lord, for me in this time, in this life, at this time in my life, when I do not see anyone else as my Lord, I believe I take you as my Lord, you see? I take you as my Lord.
Donde dice, oh Señor, en este tiempo en que no veo a... Te tomo a ti como mi Señor, mi Señor vivo.
Yeah, the other ones are gone, you see. They cannot do anything for you, you see. The other ones are gone.
Los que han ido y no están presentes aquí para que puedan hacer algo por nosotros.
Okay. Yes, so... Continuing with this Charanvidhi, you know, the more each one of you will think about this, the more the answers will come from inside. My Lord, now finally, you see, from an external gnani, the internal one awakens. The internal one becomes established, and the gnani purush dadashri has established the internal one within each one of us, okay? Establishment of the internal one.
Cuanto más profundicemos en este conocimiento, más profundamente va a estar dentro de nosotros, el Dios interno en nosotros.
Okay, so this one is being addressed. The latter, other parts of this Charanvidhi are being addressed to the one inside, you see? The one inside.
Y es el Señor que se ha establecido dentro de nosotros.
And then he says, the way in which your soul is active, let that be the way in which my soul is active. See, this third sentence, you see.
Déjame experimentar el alma de la misma forma que tú la experimentas.
¿Sí? Now, in the soul of the gnani, this is the absolute state of the gnani, whereas the soul of we mahatmas is a shifting one. Sometimes we are amapura, sometimes we become patricia and Christian, you see? It shifts back and forth.
En esta oración lo que estamos pidiendo es constante, porque hoy en día lo que nos pasa es que en algún momento somos alma pura y en otro momento me vuelvo patricia.
Sometimes it becomes
Yoda o así.
Go on. I'm here. I'm just trying to. I'm listening.
Yes, I have just said that at some moments we are Alma Pura, and then I am Patricia or Christian or Shuda. We are not, we are asking for being the whole time Alma Pura.
Yeah, so is, but what does being the Alma Pura mean? Then the answer is the Gnani never lets that which is belongs to the null self become part of himself. You see, he keeps the non-self, the mind, body, speech, activity and interactions completely separate from who he really is. You see, the separation, the separated state is absolute. You see, the separated state, that is called the conduct of the Gnani.
Bueno, acá habla de la conducta del Gnani y esto de pedir, de estar en, todo el tiempo en presencia de la acción, de los pensamientos, es la conducta del Gnani. Y esto es lo que estamos pidiendo cuando pedimos estar en absoluta presencia y separados de todo lo que tiene que ver, la separación de todo lo que tiene que ver con el no ser.
Yeah, does not allow the separated, does not allow the real and the relative to mix at all, you see. Does not allow, you see, the real and the relative to mix in any way.
Esto lo que no permitir que se vuelvan a mezclar lo real y lo relativo, que se mantenga la separación.
And the maintenance of the separation is directly a reflection of the energy of the self only, the energy of the Amapura, the energy of the self, you see. The energy of the self keeps the separation, you see. It's the energy of the self that keeps the separation, not the energy of the non-self, you see.
Es la energía del ser lo que mantiene la separación. Yeah. No es la energía del no ser la que
mantiene. All right. And it is this energy that has that is keeping us in this satsang. It is, you know, regardless of the physical or the relative circumstances of our body, our mind, or everything that is happening around us, it is this energy that is active within us that brings us to this satsang, you see.
La energía del ser, la que mantiene la separación y lo que nos mantiene en este satsang, más allá de cualquier situación sucediendo con pensamientos, con cualquier otra situación, es esta energía lo que nos mantiene en
this energy is called Pragna, okay, Pragna, okay, Pragna. This energy has begun within all of us.
Esta energía se llama Pragna.
Pragna, you see?
Y comenzó en el
yes. So it's a kind of a force, you see. It is a subtle force. It is not a force that you can measure. It is an internal thing, you see. You can measure an outside force. This is an external force, you see. but this is an internal energy that keeps the Sylvie from Amapura separate. You see, Amapura Sylvie. You see, Patricia Sylvie keeps it separate. Okay.
Tati es una energía que no es como las energías del exterior que pueden impactar en nuestro cuerpo. Esta es una energía que lo recibimos en el Nalvidi, es lo que mantiene la separación. Silvia o Patricia, es la fuerza, la energía que nos mantiene en el satsang.
Yeah, yes, and this is the energy. So he says, this energy, you know, he may ask that the way in which your soul is, let my soul be that way. So you know that you and I have already received much more, but these are words simply of somebody who is asking for energies, okay? These are words that are different. You and I have already entered into this energy called prajna.
Bueno, a pesar de que ya nosotros hayamos entrado en la forma de pedir, estar en separados todo el tiempo y en conciencia del alma pura, tal cual dada Shri está.
Then you see these are very, he says, let my mind and intellect, you see, let my mind and intellect be surrendered to you. Is that what it says in your Charanvidhi? Let me just share it and see. Let my mind and intellect be surrendered to you. Is that what he says, right?
A ver, deja que mi mente me entienda. Yes, exactly. Let my mind and my intellect be completely absorbed of you.
No, what is this word absorbed?
By you.
But what
absorbed is to be.
Absorb is not a good word. Okay, absorb is not a good word. The correct word is let my intellect and let my mind be surrendered to you. Surrendered.
Entonces, dice el Suda que la palabra correcta no es absorbido, que la palabra entregado, rendirme, que mi mente y mi intelecto sean absolutamente entregados a ti. I can't hear you, Shuda. I can't hear. You're mute.
And let me just unmute. Let the mind and the intellect, let my mind and my intellect be surrendered to you, my Lord. I mean, I just, when you are there, then I let this mind be quiet and let this intellect be not be used, okay?
Deja que mi mente y mi intelecto dejo a ti, mi Señor, y que mi intelecto no esté allí molestando, que quede de lado.
So you see, just make a note that in your next version of the corrections, we need to correct that, okay, for the Charanvidhi.
Okay.
Yeah, see, because you cannot, absorption comes much later. First you have to surrender, you have to let go of this sense Because your mind and your intellect are the basis of your ego, you see? So you have to surrender those, Okay? Patricia? I'm sorry, we are having so much difficulty. I have